Good evening, welcome back. We're here, and we're here for the second of two games that that we're casting tonight. It is StarLadder. It is an unofficial cast, but you know, unofficial ones is normally like, it's not really legal, but stuff that's normally not supposed to happen is normally best. So I don't know how I can actually put that into words. It sounds way better in Dutch. Anyways, let's get into the draft, and of course, also let's welcome my co-caster AdmiralBulldog. Welcome back.
Hello.
Hello.
Yay.
Are you ready?
Okay. Yes, I already.
Are you sure?
We have a like and dire.
Yeah, we do.
I've seen too often.
So this could either be, this could potentially be a very fast game, I think.
Yeah, it probably won't last very long. Usually if you have like and dire, you either get a huge advantage early and just roll with it. But personally, I don't think Lycan is that scary anymore. Like, he's obviously good, but okay, they're going some serious rat Dota here.
Yeah. Well, a lot of the usual suspects again. We've got Tinker banned out as well as Bat, Skywrath, Death Prophet, and then Razor Centaur picked up against the Nature's Prophet and a Lycan. I like the Centaur against the Lycan, actually. That's normally, from my point of view, pretty good. And he can also take those wolves out real fast. So I think that NVMI is prepared for this. It's just a question of how is the early stage going to go. I feel like that is the thing that, like, previous game, of course, at some point when the game goes late enough, it doesn't matter anymore who is ahead or who is behind. It all comes down to just positioning and just catching people out of mistakes. But I think it's going to come down to the early game again in this game in regards to how much can that Razor get? How fast can the Centaur get his Blink Dagger up? How fast can Lycan try and take down Roshan and stuff like that? What do you think?
Yeah. Well, you don't want to go late against this for sure. It's going to be really, like, it can get to the point where they can't push because you just get split pushed, and when eventually you start pushing, you're just going to lose anyway because you've gotten out farmed. So they really need to, NVMI has to, they need to end early. Has to be their plan. They have to probably go aggressive this game, which is a bit scary against the Prophet because he can TP there. Mm-hmm. But they need some tower push basically right now. They need to have a good early game, which they have. They have Razor lane, which is very good. You got Centaur, who's good in 1-1.
Team pick.
And they just need to have some tower push other than Razor, and then just have a good early game, and then just roll with the towers before they can split push fast enough.
They split push against the regular push. Well, that's probably why they pick up the Visage.
Are they going to draw strats?
It seems like they might. I mean, what can Team Tinker really do against that right now? Nothing anymore. So if they want to pick it up, they can. And with that, they could push fairly fast as well. They could put Razor mid, Centaur on the off lane, draw safe lane, Visage support plus one.
From what I've seen, NVMI has never used Visage with that hero. They've always used it alone. And they've done it successfully. It's only C9 that uses Visage and
Drow.
Yeah, so... But always when you see a Visage like this, it just looks like a Drow, and it's really helpful for Razor as well. It's going to hit really hard, and it's definitely a pushing hero with these heroes, and the Visage can just defend with his birds a little bit and anti-split push to some degree. So, it can work with the Visage. The Drow. It's a little bit scary though against Lycan, because if Lycan gets its farm and gets his BKB, he's got Necro 3, and you just right-click the draw, you know, what the fuck is he gonna do? Yeah, Centaur, but I don't know if he's gonna help that much.
Well, that's probably what Tinker is kind of thinking about as well. Are they gonna go for a draw? Because if they are... Oh, Shadow Demon. Actually, do those illusions count to turn off her aura?
I don't think illusions count. I'm pretty sure it doesn't. I think it's only heroes.
Okay.
So,
the demonic purge is of course pretty good against the stampede. So that's good.
It's a defensive hero.
Yeah.
So it works out. It's hard to say what you're really going for right now. With the Prophet, I think it's usually quite good at plays Prophet, but since they have, he also usually plays Lycan as well.
Remaining.
So it's probably Pike that plays Prophet and Koikwa on the Lycan, because I've not seen Sing Sing play it.
Time. Me neither.
So it's probably quite well Lycan, and it means probably mid and Prophet offlane, I would think.
Yeah. Actually, the drow, I guess if NVMI was going to go for the drow, they would have picked it by now.
Yeah, I mean, you obviously don't have to go draw with Visage. Visage alone is a really good hero. He's really good in a defensive trilane, and it's really good in aggressive as well. His burst is super high. He's very slow, though, which is his weakness, really. It looks like... I'm not sure what they're going to do here. I think the next pick is going to reveal a lot. Yeah, and Centaur versus Prophet is very good as well. Okay, Puck.
Dire team pick.
Puck is pretty good against the Prophet as well. Offers a lot of control to the team so far. I mean, they've got already, I would say, the better of control with Team Tinker just going for a split push and not really going for a fighting build, but NVMI is really preparing for fights. And with the Puck, though, you can't really run away from it, even if you are in wolf form, because you're going to get stuck in a Dream Coil and Centaur will come up behind you and will probably get a hoof stomp off, so... I like it. It's also a hero that is pretty difficult to shut down early on, and with Team Tinker having a Shadow Demon so far, I don't think that's going to change that, so... Unless Team Tinker picks up a support that is very good in roaming, like, how are you going to try to shut the Puck down? I think if Puck gets a Blink Dagger, if Nature's Prophet and Lycan are not doing better than expected, they have got a pretty tough game ahead of them.
Yeah, it's a good Puck game. They're not going to be able to gank him mid, and he's probably... Like, they can lane any way they want right now, but it's probably Puck offlane, I would think, and Centaur safely in trilane, maybe? Like, yeah, they can do anything. They're just going to switch, depending on what Tinkerino picks, so they get good lanes, but...
10 seconds remaining.
Well...
Oh,
it's the Shadow Demon Lashrak. Radiant team ban. We're going back like 1.5 years into the draft. I mean, it's a good roaming duo, but it also is very risky because I feel like if they don't get kills out of their roams, they're gonna get so far behind.
Yeah, it's basically like that for most dual roaming. If it fails the ganks, then they can turn out to be pretty useless.
5 seconds remaining.
And I mean, Shadow Demon Lashrak is being picked now and then, not so often. But it's pretty good.
Reserve time.
It's gonna mean it's pretty now. It's very like I don't think you can go aggro at least now, because if they go aggro against three heroes, then Fear and TP is in. I mean, you lose that trilane. So they have to go safe lane now. We'll probably put Puck off lane.
Puck off lane, Razor mid. Central safe lane.
Yeah, because they need to at least force some fights and stuff like that. And if they have Centaur free farming, getting early dagger, TP's top, just blinks, stomps someone and dies, that's probably the best way they want to play this game. I don't think they want to take... If they take this late, it's going to be pretty damn hard for them, I think.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Although I think they're doing pretty well in terms of not making it go late, just having a fairly aggressive heroes. It's a treant that gets removed against NVMI, with the Pugna removed against Team Tinker. I mean, you don't want to deal with more push. Of course, Lashrak alone with the Edict is it's very scary and very stupid to deal with. But it works, so makes sense. So more pushing heroes removed. For NVMI, though, I was not really expecting a treant. More expecting
remaining.
Something with an extra disable that can really help the Visage. Something like a
Five
Sand King or something.
Remaining.
Yeah, I think it's pretty open. They can pick. I mean, it's so hard to predict how they're gonna lane right now.
Maybe a Nikon.
So it's hard. They probably just want to go safe lane.
They
probably want a jungler, I think, would be pretty good for them.
Whoa. I was not expecting that one. All kinds of heroes went through my head, but Naga was not one of them.
Well, it's. I mean, they could do something weird and put Naga as a farmer, which would mean Puck. Support or something, so that's probably not very likely. It's gonna be Naga support, who is, I mean, Naga is a good counter to Lycan because he just nets him when he BKBs. And the sleep is always useful. I think Naga is gonna do a bit of a comeback. I think this hero is super strong right now, so we'll see what they can do with it.
Let's sing some zero.
Imba Spirit.
Yep, also having, like, it's a hero that's tough to gank. That's first and foremost, but extra late game potential also in terms of fights. And in terms of going uphill, which is of course something that some teams have issues with.
Okay,
and
so
actually, off like Mag is gonna play Naga Siren. It is, or rather, Mag. What am I thinking? That's the wrong team, Sheever. Thanks. No, never mind. Never mind. It's gonna be a Goblike on the Naga Siren.
Prepare for battle.
Yeah, I think they're gonna do obvious lanes now. So we'll do center off lane, safely try and puck mid.
Yeah.
Looks and like just it. Fear an off lane. And I think that just favors Team Tinkerino. You know? I mean, how are they gonna push towers? Yeah, this is, I think the draft favors Team Tinkerino a bit now, for sure.
If you still feel like it stands or falls with the performance of the supports, depending on how well the farm is. I mean, NVMI have got some decent lanes.
Yeah, I just don't like the center offlane at all. He's probably going to get zoned out, and then he gets no farm, and then you have a centaur at minute 10, minute 15, and all he has is this tranquil boots, and he doesn't do anything. I really hate that. We're Team Tinkerino, they have Furion, who just is annoying, and offlane, scout supports, get some farm here and there. So, and it's Clickwork playing profits. It's interesting.
Yep. Let's take a look at the entire lineup, because indeed for Team Tinker, they're going to be on the dire side. Quickfa is playing the offlane Nature's Prophet, picked himself up some boots, Sing will take on the mid lane as the Ember Spirit, and that leaves for a tri-lane, or semi-tri-lane rather, on top, with Pikehead farming on the Lycan, EGM playing Leshrac, and Bulba playing the Shadow Demon on support. And the reason I said semi is because I'm expecting them to rotate a lot. Both of the supports picked up a smoke, and they're probably willing to use those quite efficiently to try and take down, well, anybody actually. Preferably Scandal, but it's a very difficult hero to take down.
Oh. Yeah, it's gonna be hard for him to gank him. Yeah. I think their main focus is gonna have zone this Centaur out, and Centaur got a really bad block, and now he's not gonna get anything. This is really bad for him.
How did he get so
generally
bad
Radiant
bad
offlane block? Is very easy.
Yeah.
You get to the place where he's standing right now, and you get free experience, but yeah, he just must have missed it somehow, and this cost him a lot.
Yeah, well, we've got, of course, for NVMI, it's Illidan once again on the Razor. This time Goblike will play Naga Siren, Lil will play the Visage, and then the mid is Scandal, as already pointed out, and also, as already pointed out, DK Phobos on the Centaur. It's surprising that he is not, like, he didn't get the block, and it has such a gigantic impact. Like, he can't really go anywhere, and he went for Hoof Stomp level 1. So he can't even force out the harass damage on Bulba. Lane is gonna get pulled, or at least attempted to. He does get a 2 range creeps, yeah. But I think this is still gonna be at least a way for Phobos to actually get the lane slightly back into his favor, but at the same time the small camp is already pulled as well. Not gonna get double pulled, but it doesn't matter. The creep wave will meet like around here and everything will be A-okay if Pikehead can just hold the creep wave away from the tower. And I mean A-OK for Team Tinker, because it's still a bit bad for DK Phobos, even though we did get level 2.
It's a small mistake by Pekka to get the lane pushed there, but I mean, it happens. And they dealt with it, you know, as good as they could. They just pulled the hard camp. So all Center got from that was 2 creeps, so... And now he just can't stay there. Now the lane is going to be where Pekka stays. So he just checks the rune, runs around a bit. Yeah, sad game for him.
Quickfa managed to pick up an Invis rune and is stealing some of the experience apparently from NVMI supports.
Yeah, and Quickfa isn't getting anything either. He's got like an Invis rune here, so he's gonna get level 2, I guess. But what he's doing is he's blocking the pull camp, so the supports don't get any levels, and yeah, I guess that's fine. I'm not a big fan of doing this though. Like, when you play Prophet offlane, I think you should just screw blocking, just double pull the wave so it gets pushed into your tower, you get tons of experience and gold, and I think it's better than just blocking. But, I mean, this is fine as well.
Yeah, he actually gets the lane pushed out towards his tower right now. Even though Illidan knows where he's at, so that was kind of a scary situation, but at least the creep wave is already dead, so Illidan actually ends up taking quite a bit of damage there. Rather than Quickfa. But he's getting levels. He's level 2. And he's actually looking at level 3 here with this creep wave coming in. Or at least 2 and quite a bit. In the meantime, DK Phobos is not having any sight of getting any more farm anytime soon. Because there's 2 range creeps on the side of Team Tinker, and they will actually, rather because of that, they will see experience soon. Yay! Good for it. Let's enjoy. And I think with that,
pretty hard. It's hard for them to kill him as well. Even if they put him down, they're gonna need lightning damage to kill him, and you know he's go melee and you stomp, so
yeah,
you shouldn't be too scared in this lane, I don't think.
Well, with that, wouldn't you say that this is the perfect timing for Bulba and EGM to actually try and smoke mid?
Alright, let's see.
Oh. And snare up on Scandals. The Candle still has an orb and a phase shift. He's fine. Sixteen doesn't get the force out, and Phobos just ends up running away. That means the tower is gonna get pushed. Edict level 2. Cancel. EGM is just hoping for the fortify to be used.
EGM, please.
Yep. Do it again.
Sonic's level, he doesn't even have to use it.
He doesn't even have to use it. This is an easy tower. Who needs Edict there? No, again, nothing! There is your fortify. Well, it's too late now. Tower is in the night range already, so Team Tinker is not gonna back off. Nobody gets the last hit, doesn't matter, still goes away of Team Tinker. And that is a first tower in 4.5 minutes, helping everybody on the lane for Team Tinker.
Yeah, and this is why I hate Centaur offlane like this. You just leave him there, like... He just lost a tower because he couldn't do anything. And he's gonna be super underfarmed. And they're gonna pull back the wave now, I guess. Yeah, they're pulling back the wave, so he's like, yeah, I get some experience, but yeah, it's one wave. That's all you're gonna get.
Yep, he was so happy with that one wave.
Yeah.
Now he has tranquils. Do you feel like he should rotate into the jungle? I mean, it's not the fastest hero to be doing things in the jungle with, of course, but I feel like he might get more than what he is getting right now.
Well, it's way too slow in jungle. He should just go around, check runes, just stay top, leech some experience. That's all he really can do. Jungling, you can't just AFK jungle. It's too greedy. I mean, at least when he's stopped now, the supports have to be there.
Yeah. And that will mean that Scandal can still do what Scandal does. He's actually one last hit ahead compared to Sing Sing, but overall this lane is very even. Although Scandal is playing a bit more scared than Sing Sing, but both are alive and both are doing well. And the last hit top lane is going to be First Blood material by the looks of things. EGM in trouble and also already dead. One more hit, double ledge. DK Phobos will end up going down to the Shadow Demon with that poison stack. But nonetheless, he gets the First Blood, which is really good for him and not something that I was actually expecting.
Yeah, it was good. He needed that. Unfortunately, he died. I mean, this is one of the reasons why you just can't go AFK jungle. You have to do stuff, and they did stuff top. And it was a small favorable trade for NVMI, I guess. It's not that big of a deal. And yeah. So Lycan, this is what makes Lycan so strong in a way, because he gets his lads, and now he just jungles. And top, you have a support farming.
Yeah.
So you can't do that. He has to have the farm, and then. In my support, you just have to farm jungle, and it's going to be a big difference in farm now.
At what point do you feel like Lycan will go for the Roshan?
He could do it now, or level 7, but he'll just do it when he feels safe, I guess. He doesn't have to force it, because if he does it now, there's a chance he might go there and something bad happens. So, I mean, they're content with what's going on right now, so they're just going to keep it in this situation until they... Till they can just feel they can go safe Roshan.
In the meantime, these two supports, or at least rather these one support, because it was Bilba that actually went all the way back, but they're still making sure that this lane is constantly at least on their side of the river. And that's really hurting the center. He's level 5 right now, which is nice, but he of course would want to have already level 6. At the same time, his counterpart is actually lower level. Bilba only just got level 5 from taking down Ancients. I mean Koikva, not Bulba. But yeah, Nature's Prophet. And it looks like he actually wants to go for a Midas still.
Yeah, Koikva does that. He loves the Midas on Prophet. He almost always buys it. This is the old school Prophet build. Well, the old school would be Nago Boots. But it's
good?
Fine in this game. Yeah, it's fine in this game. I mean... Just because of the draft from NVMI, they're not going to be able to push towers, so Prophet can go greedy in this form.
Well, and Scandal really coming in. EGM, Dream Coiled, and definitely In yeah, that I really like that rotation. That was the most basic rotation that you could have. He counted on the lack of wards because it is 8 minutes in, and basically just ran top. The ward that got placed only just got placed. Nice jaunt away from Sing Sing. Still gets hit by the snare once he lands, but did he actually level it up? Is the question.
Yeah, that top gank is super important. Like, when they do something great like that and just leaves the support to farm, you have to punish it. You really have to, and they did it, and now, instead of having a free farming support there, they have a free farming centaur.
Yeah.
Which is really, really important.
But they're trying to punish it, though. They actually have a smoke up for the supports as well. Sing Sing rotating towards the bottom lane. Want to try and take down the Razor, while Goblack is actually playing a bit with Pycat. This is not the guy that you want to play with when you're level 4 up against a Lycan that is level 7. And it will form nice blocks. And that's actually Pycat in trouble. He'll still get the kill, but he'll go down with it in the meantime. Illidan trouble. Stampede gets used, trying to run, but Sing Sing coming in, and that's going to be the kill. 1-4-1 overall. Well, 1-4-2, I guess. A core for a core. Who would you put that in favor for? Is it still going to be Team Tinker because they got 2 kills? Or is losing the Lycan more important than losing a Razor?
Just delays the game, which Team Tinker wants. Any even trades his favor to Team Tinker.
Buck ultimate. rather, Major's Prophet ultimate.
Yeah, again. Just good for Team Tinkerino. Any even trades. Although that's a Puck dying, so that's not an even trade at all.
No, it's it's an extra good trade for NVMI. And they're actually leaving right now Naga Siren in the mid lane instead of Puck while he's dead. Because Naga Siren is level 4 still. I believe he is the lowest level in the game. Yes, by 2 levels he's the lowest level in the game because of what you already mentioned. Wow. I'm not joking, I swear. But Pycat, of course, went into the jungle very early on, leaving those supports to gain levels, and that's really paying off. And Roshan still falls.
Like an advantage here. Just go Roshan, you can't do anything about it.
Mm-hmm.
And not with the draft NVMI has. That's why when you have a Lycan and die, you just have to push it. And like, if they go Roshan like that, you have to get a tower for it. They got nothing for it. That's not good.
Well, looks like with that Aegis up.
And this Ember is getting really farmed as well.
Yeah, and they're not even trying to continue farming, as in they're actually actively looking for taking down those tier 1 towers. They've got the Edict maxed out to level Radiant's 4 for the Lashrak here. They've got Pycat and Sing Sing sitting Dyer's on the same lane. I mean, what can NVMI really do? Puck and Centaur are not Radiant enough to take down this onslaught, definitely not with an Aegis on board as well.
Well, I don't see them winning Radiant's a T-fight right now. I mean, they need a dagger on Puck and dagger on Centaur, and they almost have Centaur.
Oh, demonic purge from Bulba from the side. Stampede, looking like he's gonna get away, but Sing Sing jumping forward. Oh, Illidan is taking a lot of damage though, but Sing Sing is not gonna be able to finish the job. And Snare was there, and Birds as well.
Yeah, Team Tinkerino has. They're really strong in team fights right now. We get the dagger now. See if that can do something. He really needs to do something with Centaur now.
Making him a worthy pick in the meantime. Edict again used the fortification, is now on cooldown because they use it for the tier 1. But it looks like they want to go in. In comes a jump. EGM already dead, looking for the next target. And Snare catches Pycat. They have got a hoof stomp, but it's not going to be enough. And they know that too. They're actually going to run away. Trying to see if they can maybe bait Pycat into something. Looks like they just did that. In comes Sing Sing again, though. Goes for Phobos, who uses his stick charges. Is gonna live, or at least rather the mechanism came out to help him out. They get Sing Sing. Don't get the wolf, but they get Koigva. Barely, but they get him nonetheless. With Centaur. Oh, no wolves.
The trees!
Smokes.
Yes, smoke for the trees.
Smoke for the trees. Smoke for the trees. What a fight. Like, that was really a bait. The moment they started running away from that Lycan, it felt like it was a bait to try and get the Lycan, and then in comes Sing Sing as well. And that mechanism saves the day.
Yeah, they did some serious overextension there. I mean, this mech does a lot of work, and they died with 2 of their cores there. And this is exactly what NVMI needed. But still, because of the draft, I still don't think it matters too much. I think Team Tinker is still in a really good spot. Yeah, I still think they're pretty happy with where they are.
But like, yeah, what are they laying the game for? Because the late game potential is indeed in the hands of Team Tinker. And it's not like NVMI, I mean, they just want to fight, but they can't take anything off the back of it. So I'm thinking, like, what would be their best plan of action to try and take it down? Is it really that they have to hope for Team Tinker to make mistakes? Or can they make something happen themselves that can put the odds in their favor again?
Well, they have double blink soon, and that's going to help a lot. They have to just take a pick off and try to get a tower. The problem with the lineup is that they have pretty damn bad tower push.
Yeah.
They need some here to take towers easier, and they don't, which is... It's gonna be a big problem this game, I think.
Yeah, all the tier 1 towers on the side of Team Tinker are still standing. I mean, it's only 2 towers down on the side of NVMI, but with the amount of pushing potential they have, one fight won by Team Tinker can easily take down a tier 1 and a tier 2 in the same go. And that could be a big problem, as we do have people gathering up mid. Looks like the gathering point for maybe both of the teams. For Team Tinker, a bit less so, as they only have now the Leshrac as well. So the Shadow Demon just harassing the creep wave away.
Yeah, they have sleep now. It's a really good ability. They're gonna take mid tower now, it seems like. But they can't, because of split push.
If they would go for the mid tower, they would lose tier 2 top.
Yeah, this is gonna be a reoccurring problem. Since they have so slow push on towers, it's gonna be difficult. But this mid tower, it's a tier 1 and they had low HP, so this is not the most difficult, but getting tier 2 towers like this is not gonna happen, I don't think.
They need Academies on the Razor again. Is under attack.
Yeah.
I think that's gonna be their most push heavy ability this game. Not the birds.
He's not so farmed though, his problem. He's not getting much farm at all, Racer.
Yeah. He is still third highest on the net worth though, but at this point in the game it feels like farm a Lycan, or rather it doesn't even matter what kind of farm Lycan has on Aegis Prophet. They already have that pushing ability, so it doesn't like
Yeah.
They get more with their levels.
And Lycans and Prophet's farm is gonna escalate a lot. If this Racer is not going to farm fast at all, he doesn't have any places to farm. And you're just staying four people mid, just hoping someone goes for him, I guess?
Where looks like
TT,
it.
They're just all farming. Like, whatever, we're just going to farm.
Yeah, they got this covered. I mean, they have this in the bag, as they say. Oh, those sounds. I wonder, can you do that in professional matches, in lobby games? I guess you can't.
Can't, I tried. I'm sad.
That is quite sad.
You can do taunts though, which is fun.
Nice.
Hero animations. Yeah, they're just gonna wait for Roche now. Team Tinker, you know, just gonna farm.
Yeah, and Team Tinker, while farming it, they know exactly what NVMI is doing. Their wards are actually really perfect. They've seen the Visage and the Centaur moving past like three times in the same area right now, walking back and forth. They've seen Scandal as well as Illidan rotate top.
Since they see that they're rotating top once now, they want to kill her.
They see the Courier as well, and they probably want to try and maybe make something happen. TP away happens, Scandal still there by himself. Now jumps away after he sees the wolves die, realizes that he got scouted out. And the Visage moves back past the ward. Someone must have had like great fun seeing the Centaur and the Visage just moving back and forth in that ward.
Yeah.
And they weren't even farming at first. They only just started. They were just trying to help out. Stampede used. Mid. My bad. I knew it was somewhere.
Yeah. Just EGM. Just way EGM. Out of position there.
Finally, like, someone came to mid lane.
They even see the ward. Like,
I just pointed out. Yeah.
Yeah. But he probably got so confused, not sure where he was going, because he was near so much.
Yeah, I guess so. At some point, you're getting used to seeing that Centaur dot moving around.
Yeah, you got mindfucked there.
Yep.
And they smoked right on top of the ward, so that ward...
Well, apparently the smoke still helps, because Bulba was not away fast enough, and it's gonna result into a kill going away from NVMI, and perhaps with that kill, tier 1 tower? Can it actually happen?
It's a big win. But... Yeah, the problem is that they have slow tower push, and here comes...
Here comes the... Yeah, and the mid lane split push. Quite far already on the ball. We have the split push in top lane for Pika as well. Oh, they're gonna try and go for this. Dream Coil misses, actually! Sing Sing is gonna get slept, though. I'm not sure if that can's gonna be enough. He has got his spirits up. They're going for Fortify instead. And Snare will be there while he tries to TP out. Should be there. There we go. Whoa! Sing Sing, though, still gonna be able to kill off one, both of them. Loses Quake Fight. Doesn't matter. Gets two kills off the back of that. They do lose their tier 1 tower for Team Tinker, but they gain the tier 2 bottom. Top, rather. I mean, that was good trades all around. Stampede still used again for EGM. Taking him down in the bottom lane.
EGM, please. Yeah.
For more
and
worse
all
guy
NVMI is gonna get this tier 1 towers. They're not gonna get this tier 2s. It's... Yeah. All the tier 1 towers. Top is next, I guess, but it's not gonna do anything really. Just gonna keep pushing, and this is really hard game for NVMI. I think they got a little bit outpicked in this game.
Just like it. Sing Sing has got an Invis rune, finds himself DK Phobos, who tries to teleport out, and actually is gonna be able to do that.
What an outplay.
Press.
Click TP.
Click TP is all you need to do. It's gonna be Roshan number 2 for Pycat. I don't think that NVMI realizes this is going on, or even has the potential to actually do something against it. Last time they tried, they of course had some people dying.
We can't all 5 be there, because if they're all 5 there, then they get split pushed.
Yep, well, let's see. The birds flying in. Familiar is gonna actually die before it really hits the ground.
Surprise he hasn't used his Necro 3. This is gonna cost
him. Sing Sing is gonna be jumping out. We'll be jumping back in shortly. Boba in some trouble. Stampede coming out as well. Look for DK Phobos. Finds himself. EGM again. One horseman. Killing the other horse guy, and it's Sing Sing that's the last one alive, and will jaunt himself away. But it's 3 dead on the side of Team Tinker, and Roshan goes the way of NVMI. Or is it Sing Sing? He doesn't get anything, and he dies. He had to try, though. If he got that, it would have been amazing, but he had to try. I'm not going to blame him for that
I am. It's a very careless move.
But wouldn't you have praised him if it actually worked?
Yeah, but it's still... too risky. It's too high risk for... I mean, the reward would have been decent. This wouldn't even have mattered that much, I think. It's just too risky to play, and it's a high value kill.
It is.
Not even gonna get tower. Like, if he didn't do that, they could have defended mid easily enough. Now they might lose this tower.
Well, and with that, if they actually get that tower, but again, if Illidan gets the last hit on the tower, he would be extremely close to having his Aghanim's up. He's only 700 gold away right now, so he would almost have it. And with that, I think the path of NVMI is open once again after that fight. And Illidan does get the last hit, so 100 gold away right now. We have the Haven's Halberd being completed as well. We do have some Necronomicon books done as well. Quakefy gets his level 2, or 3 rather, on the book. And we have level 3 on the Lycan. We already had that. And we have got... no, that's it. 2 Necro 3s. But NVMI are actually pulling this together real nice.
Yeah, but it's mainly because Team Tigrino does some big mistakes. Like on that Roche, the Lycan is sitting on Necro 3 and he doesn't use it to kill the Roche first. Like the DPS is increased by a lot if he has Necro 3 and he's just sitting there slowly farming it. You could just use Necro 3, use ult, kill it like twice as fast, but because he didn't. They gave time for an NVMI to get there, so they got the Roche, they got tier 2 tower because of that, they got 4 kills because of that. These small things lead to so big things, and yeah, it's probably not gonna make the mistake again.
Yeah, I still have that split push. And all NVMI needs to do is win one big team fight when the lanes are not too far pushed out towards their towers, and they can take a lane of Rex with the Aghanim's up on the Razor, I think. If they win a good team fight. And they have most of the kills so far. I mean, it's only 15-6. And I say only. It's still almost a kill per minute because we're only 23 minutes into this game.
Yeah. I mean, if you look at the kills, it looks like it's good for NVMI, but still, this split push is still going to be a problem. Luckily, though, this racer's got his Aghanim now, so terror pushes this a lot faster.
Yeah, with the fight, actually. Take a look at the experience graph. That's what one fight did. It's just...
yeah,
7,500 experience in favor of Team Tinker. And NVMI just got a tower for free on the top lane by the looks of things. Actually, no, not for free, because Lycan got himself a tower on the bottom lane with just his creeps because he wasn't there himself. Well, he was hanging back, rather. So tier 1 for tier 2, again.
Yeah, these trades.
Dire's top tower is under
attack. Yeah, at some point this Team Tinker is gonna have to fight the NVMI. And if you look at his ref, then I think they're pretty okay with that. I mean, they got the tanky Lycan just running in. And he's getting good farm and his Ember is just gonna stand back, use his spells, tons of damage. Yeah, so I think they're pretty okay with the situation still. Even though they're doing these mistakes and everything is going... Everything could have gone so much easier for Team Tinker if they didn't make these mistakes. But still, they're in a decent situation, I think. Goblock going some serious YOLO here. He's all by himself.
Yeah, he is gonna be forced to use his song. I mean, he's level 11, so that's nice for him. But it's still an expensive spell to be using just for him, as he is, of course, playing Dyer's a support role.
However, he was doing some serious space grading there. They might get the top tower because of that.
Yeah, if the storm turned on, let's see how much damage they can actually do. The three familiars coming out from the Agony Scepter Visage as well.
Here you have your tower damage.
Yep. Dyer's top tower only one tower remains on both teams. I guess the towers are back to being even.
Yeah,
good news for NVMI.
This fight was so bad for Team Tinkerino. They lost so much on it.
And they didn't even get anything. Apart from the song, which is back up again in just over a minute.
Dyer's top tower is under attack.
And they're not planning on pushing in anymore, because I mean they're still in Aegis on the side of the Razor, so it's still a risky team to try and fight, so they have to actually get it from the split push at this point. But it's
Dyer's
under control.
Top tower is under attack.
NVMI have
it. This center is getting pretty good farm actually. I think NVMI is not in as bad situation anymore. I mean, obviously they've been in a pretty good situation now, but yeah, they're doing pretty good right now. So we'll see how this goes. Everyone is getting really farmed.
Oh, Prophet. Scandal, rather. Oh, Scandal, I meant to say. He's dead. Flip pushing, not really his strong suit, not when he's up against two. He's gonna be maybe opening for Team Tinker. Nah, probably not actually. They just gotta continue doing what they were doing. Just split push, just keeping their lanes pushed out. In the meantime, those supports, of course, are gonna be trying to get some farm as well, which is pretty difficult to do. Because the downside when someone's trying to split push is like they're farming all over the map. Nature's Prophet, Lycan, an Ember Spirit. Good luck to Lushrak and Shadow Demon. They have to really get the fights, get the kills, farm from the towers. From last hits, as actually Stampede is used, proud up for Illidan, who's gonna be able to teleport out by the looks of things. Indeed makes it out alive, and that is that was pretty close. Tower down to half though.
It's one of those small mistakes again. Obviously, Shadow Demon should be the one TPing first, not Lycan. But in the heat of the moment, it's hard to make those coordination or those things there to time it all. But yeah, missed a kill because of that. It happens.
Indeed it
and,
does.
Yeah, this racer, I wonder if he's gonna go the refresher already. I don't think so. I think he needs a BKB or... Yeah, he needs a BKB, I think, and then refresher. And at that point, they could easily go tier 3. Yeah, Team Tinker, you know, gonna do their thing, just keep pushing waves and farm.
Exciting game plan. Very exciting game plan, and very restless for the supports indeed. Taking a look at the other supports, I feel like that a Visage as a support and a Naga Siren as a support later on in the game have a way bigger impact than a Lushrak and a Shadow Demon. What do you think?
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, this Visage is also getting tons of farm. I mean, one of the things you underestimate if you don't play often against Visage is if he slows you, use die on you, like you die. Even carries die from this.
Just a solo for one versus one, you mean?
And even in teamfights, whomever, if Visage doesn't get focused and he can just use his spells on one hero, that hero dies from these three birds. It's so high burst. It's insane.
Well,
I mean, even the Lycan. Even Lycan. If he gets stunned or something.
Let's see if Scandal is in trouble. Yules up that first. Let's see. Phase shift. Nicely dodging the stun. And Scandal silencing, trying to orb away. No longer silence himself. And is going to be able to make it out. Or is he not? The disruption is still there. Another Yules coming out. And that one was his was his own, trying to blink. He can't. No, he can't. The vision. Nature's Prophet Ultimate gets him in the end.
This ward, MVP. Give vision for Fury and ult.
Yep, that's true. Oh, that's so close.
Space created.
Is that worth it with the four people going on him?
They lose nothing because he didn't get anything on it, NVMI. This is exactly what they wanted.
Well, it puts, bottom lane has got some issues as well. Sing Sing and Boba in some trouble. Illidan not able to steal a lot of damage. And Bird's slowing them down though. It looks like NVMI is the one to back off in the end. In the meantime, on the top lane has a bit of an engagement as well, where the Centaur is fighting a Lycan, but we're following this fight. It is Illidan hexed up, mech'd up as well, and that's Boba already dead with the Aghanim's ulti on. Doesn't matter, too much damage coming out with the Howl as well. Visage kills off the Nature's Prophet, but Visage himself got killed off by Sing Sing, who just cleans up other people's messes. In the meantime, that fight on top lane, it's a good thing that we didn't follow that, because nothing really happened. Lycan didn't die, the Centaur didn't die, the tower didn't die, even though it did take a bit of damage. But overall, that bottom fight, I put that in favor of Team Tinker.
Yeah, for sure. And another bad thing for NVMI is that when this ember gets some more items, I mean, these birds get cleaved on, so they will die. They will be useless in team fights. It's pretty sad for this Visage.
Well, we almost have a Defusal Blade up on Goblin, so he'll be having a bigger impact as well, and he's just trying to farm the jungle as best as he can. It's going, of course, very slow, but for a support, not doing too bad, to be honest. Still second lowest in terms of net worth and lowest for his team, but regardless, he'll get there. His song alone is, of course, a great teamfight contribution. 2700 gold up EGM. What do you think he's going to buy?
EGM. Well, maybe a BKB or a Bloodstone, probably. It's hard to say.
Well, he's saving up gold for something. It's like a fun time with that as well. And both teams back to farming. For NVMI, it's basically licking their wounds and making sure that they still get their core items up. And for Team Tinker, is this their strategy? Just go for the split push. Have all lanes push out and then see if you can take Roshan and if you can maybe go high ground on one side, or maybe hope that someone gets picked off. And they go in off the back of that. I mean, they've been able to pick off Scandal twice on the top lane.
This Roshan is going to be very important. NVMI needs this to push base. But for them to kill it, they don't have too good damage on this one. Top is just pushing, and someone has to TP there, and if they TP there, they will lose short fights. It's such a frustrating situation.
Well, we already have got teleport cancelled from Phobos, wants to be hero instead. Gem on the floor in the meantime. Because Naga Siren just got killed by the Ember. Them all standing so close to each other made that Battle Fury really work for them. Shadow Demon still gets picked up. Illidan taking so much damage. Xing Jin just has to stand there and gets a kill. Now he goes forward, gets the Visage, heals up in the air for EGM so he doesn't die, as Xing Jin still ends up going down. That is going to be buybacks upon buybacks. They did lose the Rex on the top lane, as that was Pykas doing worth it for Team Tinker, even though they lose four. They get Rex and they get a buyback up on two people and end up buying back on their Lycan as well, because Lycan wants to be there for the Roche kill. And the Roche kill goes away for Team Tinker as well. They lost four people in the fight, still somehow managed to win it.
Yeah, this is such an easy game for Team Tinker to play.
It's a bit of a text.
Oh, are they going to make it?
No, they're going to go in again.
Oh, so close.
That's going to be too late. And Lycan already has the Aegis. He goes for it anyway. Gets a double stun off. Illidan has not got his Eye of the Storm up. Koikfa is going to be the target. Pyke ran away, and Koikfa will get picked off. Maybe Scandal in trouble. Uses himself up in the air. There's still three people around here from Team Tinker. Hoofstomp gets Sing Sing. He dies. And that was dies again, indeed. Boba in some trouble. Soul Assumption. Whoo! Dodges it, but it's just a delay of execution. Will end up getting picked off by the Eye of the Storm that was up again. Can't really result into a tower because all the lanes are too far pushed out towards NVMI's base. They don't get the Aegis because Lycan was the one to pick up the Aegis and he ran. They get something. Do you feel like they get their worth at least for the buyback, or is that just like just basically not worth it?
It's just a sad game for NVMI. They get these Team-wise, it doesn't do anything, really. They're not gonna be able to push here. Or, well, they're gonna try, actually. Racer almost has ult. I mean, they know they have to try this, at least, because they can't delay the game anymore. They're getting too split-pushed. So they need to go for these racks. They can't back off, because then they're just gonna lose for sure.
Oh, and Lycan, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. He's thinking maybe he's at two lives, baiting it out. EGM turns on his BKB, trying to run, will be able to. Goes for Goblack, actually, and that's gonna be a song, but Goblack dies anyway because the BKB was, of course, still on Pyke with the BKB. Big, gigantic wolf will be able to help kill off Illidan. DK Phobos running away, doesn't really know where to go. Has got a hoof stump, though. Will be able to use it, but doesn't hit anybody with it because Pyke was already long gone. It is three dead on the side of NVMI. They have to leave. Lil will be trying to teleport out amongst everybody. We'll be able to make it out as the only one, as we did see Centaur still getting picked off by the Nature's Prophet. Few birds getting picked off as well, only one remaining. Once again, Team Tinker wins a fight. And it all started with a bait by the Lycan. Do you feel like that was a bait? Because it looked like just a really stupid action, but it might have just been a bait to try and make them all commit to the fight.
Yeah, he just wanted to create some time for his team to spawn, because he knew he'd just BKB as soon as he spawned, and then just BKB and ult, and then they can't kill him anymore, and then his team spawns, and yeah, it was just such a hard fight for NVMI to do, but they had to do it, and they failed it, and that probably is just the game right there. I don't think they can try that again, because they're just going to lose 100%, and well, what else can they do? They're really in the corner right now.
Hope that Team Tinker makes a mistake. Yeah. Looks like that's all they can do. They don't have a song anymore either.
You have to make multiple mistakes. That's the sad part.
Pyke taking a bit of damage. He still has his BKB. He knows it too. Gets hexed up before he can use it though. Maybe they can kill him up before he can use his. No, he can't. Disruption comes out and Pyke is wolf and BKB'd and kills off the Razor together with Bulba. that Ember! Able to just cleave people to death, burn people to death. Goblack will be able to teleport out. He's teleporting from here to the fountain. That's how he got there. And still ends up going down because he made illusions that got cleaved and he cleaved himself to death. Now it's only Centaur left alive, and I mean, I guess he might be too tanky to take down, but in the meantime, it is Team Tinker that is clearing out the base of NVMI, and I think that with that, they end keeping themselves on top of the rankings. They keep their number one position with still only one loss to their name in the StarLadder rankings. Would you say outdraft or outplayed or both?
Well, it was just pure case of just outdrafts. I mean, when you see this like in your first two, you have to have pushing heroes. You have to go either aggro, you just have to put a lot of pressure on enemy team, and they didn't have that. They didn't have any Terra push early game. They had to wait for this Racer, Aghanims, and it's not enough. They didn't put any pressure early game, and that's why they lost. It was just pure outdraft.
Well, NVMI definitely then still have something to learn, not the drafting king, as Goblack is sometimes called, but a lesson learned. They did, of course, win their earlier game, so they are still doing okay on the rankings, but with that loss, they actually move to the score of 3-3, while Team Tinker is now 9-1 in Star Series, so doing really well and almost securing their space in the LAN finals for StarLadder Star Series. The top four of the 16 teams will move on. For more information about that, you can go to dota2.starladder.tv. You can actually set the language to English so you don't have to read Russian if you can't. Thank you for joining me, Bulldog. If you want to have any shoutouts or plugins, then you can.
Shout out to Koikra. We're playing Prophet.
Really?
That's all.
That's all? No sponsors or what? No?
No, okay. I want to.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining me. I had fun. First game was a bit long. Second game...
It was really good, though. It's a really fun game to watch,
yeah.
The first game.
More fun than this one, though. This one was a bit...
Yeah.
Kind of one-sided in the end. I mean, they had some nice goes, and they had some mistakes from Team Tinker that they could actually build upon, but in the end... Just overpowered.
Yeah. Sad game.
Sad game indeed. Yeah. We'll be back another time, because not tonight anymore. This was the last game of the night. Thank you for joining us, guys. And I just looked at the tip jar. Thank you for tipping. Because, of course, this is an unofficial cast. And this was the first time me trying out the tip jar thing. Let me know what you think. If you have, like, some strong thoughts about that, you can send me a Twitch message, because I'm curious about that. Anyways, thanks for watching. Thanks for joining. And have a great night. Bye-bye.
Bye.